Hey, what's up, everybody? Danny K here, Sonic Flair. Thanks for tuning in. This is my very first video. Well, actually, the second video, if you discount the fact that I did my intro video to my channel just earlier today. But thanks for joining. Thanks for coming on. And I was trying to figure out, okay, what am I going to launch this channel with, right? There's got to be some big bang thing that is going to catch everyone's attention and hopefully make everyone watch and, you know, tune in and all that good stuff. So, without further ado, what is the one thing that has been talked about ad nauseum by everyone in hi-fi and music and audio? Of course, it is nothing other than the number one selling jazz album of all times. And of course, that is none other than Miles Davis, Kind of Blue, of course. What else would it be? So, I figured the reason, why am I picking this album? Well, there's a couple of reasons. One, again, it's the best-selling jazz album of all times. Number two, it's been 63 years since the release of this, which is kind of hard to believe. It's 2021. This came out 63 years ago, right? And number three, really the one of the main reasons is Chad Kasem, Acoustic Sounds, is releasing Miles Davis Kind of Blue on UHQR on 33 and 45. The 33 was just announced last week. And it's 25,000 copies, so I would get my order in. Trust me, you're not going to want to miss this one. And at some point later, he's going to do the 45 RPM of it. So what I thought of doing was, hey, until my copy arrives, which, you know, hopefully is going to get here by May, you know, I think the street date is May 21st, if I'm not mistaken. So I figured what I would do is, you know, obviously I have more than one copy of Kind of Blue. And so I figured what I would do is show you guys, well, first of all, do a little bit of bragging because I've got all kinds of copies of Kind of Blue. There's probably six or seven copies in here. So anyway, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a quasi shootout of Kind of Blue, except for UHQR, right? And so what I'm going to start with, and then when UHQR comes out at the end of the month, we'll revisit it. And with a little surprise, and we'll do the ultimate test at that time. But for now, here's what we have to look at, okay? So the first one, I have to say, this is my one of my prized possessions. This is an original Kind of Blue 6i Columbia with a stone mint cover. I'm not kidding you, folks. This is, I don't think I've ever seen this record with a cleaner cover than this. It cost me a pretty penny, but I'll tell you a funny story. A couple of years ago, I had a friend of mine visit, and he literally offered me $900 on the spot for this record because of the cover. And of course, the record itself is great. The cover is just, it looks like it was printed and pressed yesterday. Seriously, it's absolutely gorgeous. Of course, I have it protected in my little sleeve here, but phenomenal. So that's the original, right? Then we have, I guess if I go in chronological order, we have the Classic Records reissue that came out in 1997. And Classic Records, of course, you know, Kind of Blue, right? What I would urge you to do, yesterday, Acoustic Sounds, so Chad Kasem, Gary Salstrom, Bernie Grundman, the original mastering engineer for the reissue, Mike Hobson, of course, of Classic Records. My dear friend, Michael Ludwigs from 45 RPM Audiophile. And of course, none other than, no, not me, Michael Fremmer. So there's what, three Michaels on that show? Gosh, how did they keep them apart? Anyway, Michael Fremmer joined a discussion that Chad kind of hosted for the upcoming UHQR. It runs just a little over 2.5 hours. I think it's 2 hours and 35 minutes. It came out yesterday. You can see the link on Acoustic Sounds YouTube channel. I strongly would encourage you to watch it. There is such a gobload of info from historic perspective. you know, the quality of the reissues that are out today, what's coming out with UHQR, why the UHQR is going to be so special, not just for the Miles Davis release, obviously, for really the two previous releases and any future releases that Chad is going to do. Gary does such a phenomenal job of educating the concept behind UHQR. And then, of course, you hear great stories from Bernie Grundman, you know, Mike Hobson, you know, Michael Fremmer does his usual, you know, showmanship. So anyway, I would encourage you to watch that video. But the classic records kind of blew. What's special about it is this. I'll just kind of rehash it in, you know, 60 seconds or less. It was the first time that Sony gave out the three-track tapes. There were four machines running, 2 3-track recorders and 2 mono recorders. It was the first time that Sony gave the 3-track tapes to a reissue company, Mike Hobson in this case, and let them run. Bernie Grundman did this in his studio in Hollywood. A new, not only a new mix down to 2-track, but the record was actually cut live from the 3-track master straight to the lacquer and cutter head, right? That, I don't believe, has ever been done before, and certainly not since, and certainly not ever again with Kind of Blue. So that is what's so special. You are essentially eliminating one entire generation of the 3-track tape being mixed down to 2-track, and that 2-track tape then being used to cut the lacquer. So they eliminated that. Bernie, the genius that he is, and he truly is one of the greatest, if not the single greatest mastering engineer we have. He does incredible work. He's still very active today. But anyway, what he was doing was he was cutting it live to the lacquer. And of course, it gave you that absolutely pristine "You Are There" sound that, you know, nothing short of a Stone Mint original. And even there, I would argue that the classic records probably sounds better in certain cases. To me, anyway, it does. And so they of course did the 33, and then they did the 45 RPM. And of course, in typical Mike Hobson fashion, he, you know, the perfectionist that he is, and he really is, or was at the time of owning Classic Records, an absolute perfectionist when it came to reissues. In fact, I think really, you know, we owe him a sense of gratitude for all the amazing RCAs and Columbias and Blue Notes and all the amazing rock records, you know, Led Zeppelin, Hello, Hello. That Classic Records reissued. It was his, you know, absolutely maniac, fanatic attention to detail that got us the sound quality that we did. And so, you know, kudos to Mike Hobson and Classic Records, and of course Bernie Grundman for having done such an awesome job. And so what Mike did for the 45 RPM is he launched this new concept of not only reissuing a 45 RPM record, but actually covering and laying it out on 4 records, right? So you would have side one on one record, side two on another record, side three, and so on and so forth, right? So you would have 4 records. The other thing that's interesting about the Kind of Blue that Classic did is it kind of dates back a little before to where Mark Wilder, another incredible engineer, discovered that the tape was actually running, I think it was like just a tick over 1%, 1.25%, if I'm not mistaken, too slow. And so the pitch was off on side two of the record. And so they speed corrected that. And it was also the very first time that, you know, Classic Records or anyone else really released the record at the correct speed of what it should have been, right? So not even the original mint condition you may get or have or own has the correct speed on side two, right? Because I suppose you could have if they were using, but I don't think so. Anyway, I'm getting into the weeds of it. Post a comment below if you want to correct me if I'm wrong. But to my knowledge, I don't believe that there is an original out that has the correct speed on side two. Anyway, continuing our quest of awesome reissues, I think chronologically speaking, the next one that's up is the 50th anniversary that came out in 2008. And again, folks, hard to believe 63 years ago this record came out. Very nicely done. Beautiful jacket by Sony. They did a really nice job. It's a gatefold. It's got some great liner notes in here. And then, of course, it has the two CDs and the DVD. I tried playing the DVD in my record player, and it didn't quite work. Anyway, stupid joke. I get it. Hey, they were staring at me. I had to do it. What do you want me to do? I can't look at DVDs and not come up with a crazy joke, right? So here's the thing. What's really cool, here's the story on this record. Mark Wilder mixed the 3-track to 2-track stereo. That's what was used for this reissue. It's pressed on cool blue vinyl, which is neat. And then, of course, I think really what sells this record, and I strongly would encourage you, apparently Chad still has a bunch of these 50th anniversaries. I would strongly encourage you to get it because it comes with this absolutely amazing and beautiful booklet. It's really not a booklet. It's more like a nice coffee table book of session photos of the kind of blue session. So definitely encourage you to get this. It's really well done. You know, obviously the book alone is, you know, I think, you know, if you were to get this alone, it'd probably be more than $60. You get the bonus of having the blue record and two CDs and the DVD. I mean, you can't go wrong. And I'll drop a link below where you can order this. Still brand new, sealed. Chad has a bunch of them, and it's only $60. If that's all you can get, that is the issue that I would get, without a doubt, right? And then, of course, I have keeping in that chronological order, I have the mono record store date from 2013. So the mono tapes are missing. They're gone. They're, who knows where they are. They probably were copied over, taped over. Nobody cared about it. It was the beginning, you know, well into the stereo era. And so they all thought, hey, you know, what's this mono stuff, right? At least I'm guessing that's what happened. So unfortunately, we lost the mono tapes. But again, from that Mark Wilder 3-track to 2-track stereo, they did another mix down to mono. And this is what this record was cut from. All analog, speed corrected. Sounds fabulous, right? I think one of the reasons that people may prefer it is that, unlike the stereos that were cut at the time, you know, particularly jazz, hard left, hard right, panning in between, this mono, you know, just puts everybody in the middle of the room between your speakers, right? And so it just has a sort of presence that is missing from any of the other stereos, right? You know, that said, it is a mono. You know, some people don't care for that. I love mono. I got into mono about 5-6 years ago. That's going to be a whole different video. Then finally, we have what I thought was going to be the definitive last reissue of Kind of Blue, which of course is the still in print Mobile Fidelity that came out a couple of years ago as a 45 RPM, nice box set. You know, Mobile Fidelity did a great job. This is pressed at RTI, of course, as is the classic records. You know, fabulous job. This was also done from those 3-track Mark Wilder tapes that were mixed down to stereo. This is what came out as a result. So the one that's missing is, of course, Chad's UHQR. And, you know, we'll get into it when it comes out. Until then, here's kind of my ranking of what things look like on the market, right? You know, the original, again, if you have one, it's phenomenal, right? Especially if it's a mint record, which are rarer than hen's teeth. They're definitely becoming more and more difficult to find, especially with a clean cover, and be prepared to spend primo bucks for it. The next one, you know, sonically speaking, strictly sonically speaking, in my opinion, the classic records 33 and 45 are really the best sounding versions of this phenomenal record. I think you get space. I think you get substance. There is a shimmer around the instruments. There is the when Miles punches it, right? It's like 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. You really feel the musicians in the room, and it's phenomenally well recorded, beautifully remastered. Bernie did such an awesome job with this. And again, if I didn't have anything else, Desert Island, I would take the classic records with me to listen to until the end of time, right? The mono again is great. If you care for mono, B, if you are interested in really listening to the music from a very different perspective, it puts all the musicians between your speakers. There's oodles and oodles of layers between the musicians, right? Which I think is one of the misnomers that, you know, people ascribe to mono, is that, you know, everybody kind of thinks, oh, mono, it sounds flat. You know, there's no layering. You know, I want stereo, I want wide sound stage. Look, you get a wide sound stage between your speakers, and you get depths of layers that is just phenomenal, right? Once you hear it, you can't unhear it. So the mono is fantastic. And then I think last but not least, and again, this is why I was saying it earlier, the 50th anniversary from Sony, I think is a very nicely done set. Does it sound great? I don't know where they pressed it. I really have no clue. I'm pretty sure it wasn't at RTI. It definitely wasn't at Palace. I don't know what plants were open in Europe in 2008 when they pressed this, when this came out. In my opinion, the reason that you want the 50th anniversary is for this absolutely beautiful, beautiful coffee table book that has all the session photos and incredible stories on Kind of Blue, right? Beautiful liner notes, very nicely written, and it's only $60. And Chad has tons of them still left, brand new, sealed. I'll drop a link below where you can pick it up. And so that's kind of the ranking. I mean, I think again, for a record of that importance, having all of these different versions, you really listen for I guess at the end of the day, no matter, you know, the fact that the classic to me is the best sounding, you know, the there's certain elements of each of these releases that, you know, speak to themselves as to what they're capable of producing in your room on your hi-fi, right? So anyway, that's it. We're anxiously awaiting the UHQR to come out, a couple more weeks. I think we're going to have a really cool video coming with it, and with a little surprise for you guys. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for watching. Until next time, we'll see you soon. Cheers.